Good morning. You're welcome to my secret place devotion. How are you doing this morning? I'm sure you got up strong and healthy this morning. Okay, let's jump quickly into the Word of God. Today we're going to be looking at the gang up, and we're still looking at our topic, the coping strategies. We're looking the whole of this week at how people cope with different things that happen in their lives. I'm going to read the scripture, which is in Proverbs chapter 16, verse 7, which will be our text for today. And the Bible says that when a man's ways are pleasing to the Lord, he makes even his enemies to live at peace with him. I'll read that again. When a man's ways are pleasing to the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him. That's from the New International Version. Now, this verse of scripture is very important to you, especially if you are dealing with office politics or family politics, or even if it's church politics of any sort. This scripture should be a revelation to you. It should be something that you should know and utilize very effectively. But I think, let me do a small explanation of what office politics is, what we generally refer to as office politics. Now, it's a situation where people gang up against you, or people lie against you, or people do different things against you, make you look bad because they want to put you down so that they can rise. And this happens everywhere. Sometimes it is subtle, you know, it is not obvious, it is done underground. Sometimes it is very apparent. People, you know, come out of their way and you know that they are actually against you. They are doing everything they are doing because they want to pull you down. And this happens everywhere. Sometimes it happens in families. You see siblings, they are struggling because they want, you know, the father or the mother to show them more favor than this other person. So the other sibling does something little, the other brother will rush and go and report to the father or to the mother or something. You see it happening in the office, you know, where people try to make you look bad. Maybe you do something, if I even do something good, and then they try to say that that thing you did is not very good, or somebody else tries to take the credit for it, or they paint a different picture of what you really are. They do that to your boss, they do that to your superior, so that if something, some sort of promotion or some acknowledgement is meant to come in your direction, that acknowledgement will be withdrawn and given to that other person. It happens everywhere. Sometimes people are so serious about it that they even become fetish. You know, they do all sorts of diabolical things. They get into diabolical means because they want to pull someone down so that they themselves can rise. But the thing is that the way people cope with office politics is very different. What people do in terms of coping with office politics, sometimes what they do is they react. You know, they go around gossiping about the people that gossip about them. They go around spreading information about them, positive, sometimes negative information about the people that are fighting against them. You know, they run around the report, they become agitated, they fight the people, they do everything. Sometimes they even start doing their own politics in retaliation to what this other person is doing. So you see, it just becomes one gang up to the next gang up, and everything just becomes messy at the end of the day. But the thing is, how did God recommend or specify that we deal with office politics? Because these gang ups will actually show up in your life, whether you like it or not, because we are living in a world filled with men whose hearts are deceitful. The Bible says the heart of man is highly deceitful. You know, it is very corrupt, it is very deceitful. We're living in a world with people who are still living in the flesh. So once you're in an organization where there are two or three people, somebody somewhere will rise up to fight you, will rise up to make you look bad, will rise up to paint you bad, you know, in the face of other people. And you have to know how to deal with this, but you have to deal with it not the world's way, but God's own way. And we're going to look at God's own way of dealing with politics. And the Bible tells us in the scripture we just read, he said, if your ways are pleasing to the Lord, then he will make even your enemies to be at peace with you. Meaning that what? You should focus on the Lord. As long as you have found favor with God, as long as God is on your side, then you're going to win that particular battle. God is just going to make the hearts of men to be favorably disposed towards you. God is going to make it in such a way that even that plan they are planning against you, at the end of the day, will turn around for your good. You know, the Bible says something in Psalms 42, verse 1. I'll read it. He said, as the deer pants after the water, so my soul longs for you, O God. You know why the deer is always panting for water? Because the deer has a very, very strong scent. And he knows that the animals can smell him a mile away. The lion can smell him a mile away. The tiger can smell him a mile away. The only way to hide his scent is to hide inside water. The moment the deer gets inside water, the water covers his scent. And therefore, the lion can be 5 minutes away from him and still not be able to smell his scent. So the deer knows that his survival is dependent on him finding water. So he's constantly looking for water. He's constantly running to a place where he can find water, because that is his only security. And that is the same thing you should be doing. If you can stay in the presence of the Lord, if you can hide yourself in God, men cannot find your scent. Men cannot track you. The thing is that you're fighting men with their own weapons. But the Bible says that the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. You do not use physical means to fight men. The Bible tells us, the scripture we've read so far, the Bible says that when you find God, when you hide yourself in the presence of God, when you see God and you hide there, who can touch you? The Bible says, for our lives are hidden with Christ, and Christ's life is hidden in God. Which means if you obey that and hide yourself inside the hand of God, for anybody to get you, he has to first of all attack God, defeat God, then come and now meet Jesus, then before he meets you. Because remember, you are hidden in Jesus, and Jesus is hidden in God. So where would the person start from? The problem is that you will leave the presence of God and start fighting men. No, whenever this thing happens to you, whenever you sense a gang up against you, in your office, in your home, wherever it is, in your village, in your community, wherever it is, start looking for water, which is what the presence of God. Become like the deer. Start panting after God. The moment you find God, men can no longer find you. Before they get you, they have to get God. The Bible tells us something concerning Daniel in Daniel chapter 1 verse 9. The Bible says God brought Daniel into tender mercies and favor with the prince of the eunuchs. And the Bible tells us in verse 10 and 11 that the prince of the eunuchs were the ones that are directly over Daniel. So in other words, for God to be able to help Daniel, he gave Daniel favor before his direct superiors. The people who were going to talk to the king on his behalf, God made sure that those men found favor with Daniel. So Daniel was having favor with those men. Why? Because Daniel has said before in verse 7, he said, the Bible tells us that Daniel said in his heart, I will not defile myself. He made up his mind to be found in the presence of God. He said, I'm not going to defile myself with the meat that comes from the king's table. Daniel made up his mind to serve God. Daniel made up his mind to be found in the presence of God. The same thing too happened to David. You know, there was a gang up against David. Let us see David's reaction in Psalm 46. I think it might be a good idea for me to read Psalm 46 for you. It said, God is our refuge and God is our strength. I even encourage you to read that particular scripture, because Daniel understood that his strength, everything that he's doing in his life, that God is his strength, God is his source, God is his everything. So if he finds himself in trouble, you know, remember when Saul was against David and all that, what did David do? David did not bother himself going up and down looking for solution. He went and found himself inside God. So let's read Psalm 62. Let me even start reading from verse 3. He said, how long will you assault a man? Would all of you throw him down? This leaning wall, this torturing fence. Verse 4. They fully intended to topple him from his lofty place. They take the light in lies. With their mouths they bless, but in their hearts they curse. Verse 5. Find rest, O my soul, in God alone. My hope comes from him. You know, the Bible is telling you now, find rest in God alone. Don't try to fight back the way that others are fighting back. He said, he alone is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will not be shaken. My salvation and my honor depend on who? God. I'll say that verse 7 again. He says, my salvation and my honor, it depends on God, not on your boss, not on every other person. It depends on God. He said, he's my mighty rock and my refuge. I encourage you to read the whole of that verse. Because of time, I obviously can't read the whole of that chapter, but read Psalm 62 verse 1 till the end. But I'll pick one other verse from this Psalm 62 verse 11. It said, one thing God has spoken, twice have I heard, that power belongs to God, not to man. Power belongs to God. In other words, when you attach yourself to the source of power, nobody can bring you down. Before they bring you down, they have to first of all attack God. You know, one time my company was handling a big consulting job for a particular institution, and that they are like one of my biggest clients every year. You know, we've done this for them every year. Then all of a sudden, this gang up began. I wasn't even aware. You know, all of a sudden, certain people came up and they said, why is this lady, why is her company making all this money every year? For what? You know, so unknown to me, they ganged up and, you know, they started signing documents and all that. They brought in another company to take over, you know, the contract we had signed with this particular institution, and I didn't even know about it. You know, they got all the necessary approvals, they got all the necessary signatures and all of that. And they came to the table of the man to take the final decision. Now, I've never met this man before in my life, the man to take the final decision, because, you know, he's new. He was a new director on the seat. I never met him at all. All of a sudden, I got a call from this man. He introduced himself. He said he's a new director and he's never met me, but, you know, a document came to his table, and people came up and they said they wanted this other company to take over the job we've been doing for them for some time. He said, even though I've never met you, I'm a principal man, and I feel that we've never gotten any bad report from your organization, so I don't understand why they want to change you and all that. And I told them that unless I hear from you and you tell me that you're no more interested in the job, then there's no way we're going to remove your company. And so I canceled out the proposal they had brought to bring in another company to do the job. Now, note, I have never met this man in my life. He used his own credit. He did not send a text. He used his own credit and he called me, had a long conversation, told me about it, and told me what he had told them. Who did that? It was God. First of all, I was not even aware this gang up was going on against me and my organization. But you know, while this was going on, interestingly, I was traveling around the world ministering for God and doing all of that, minding my business and serving God and obeying God. God would not turn his back on somebody who is faithful and who is committed and who is serving him. So you see, when people are ganging up against you, don't fight them. Just face God. God will find a way. God will raise a man to fight on your behalf. It doesn't have to be somebody you know. It doesn't have to be your relative. It doesn't have to be anybody related to you. God will raise a man on your behalf. Then the second principle I'm going to tell you for dealing with office politics or for church politics is the man side of it, which Jesus advised the 12 disciples, you know, in Mark chapter 9, verse 35. I'm going to read it, you know. He says, sitting down, Jesus called the 12 and said, if anyone wants to be the first, let him be the servant of all. You know, because the 12 were arguing about who is going to be first. Maybe I should even read verse 33 and 34 so you'll understand this. The Bible says, they came to Capernaum when he was in the house, and he asked them, what were you arguing about on the road? But they kept quiet because on the way they had argued about who was the greatest and who would be the head. Now verse 35, sitting down, Jesus called the 12 and said, if any one of you wants to be first, he must be the very last. He must be the servant of all. In other words, apart from hiding yourself in God, the next thing you need to do is make sure in that organization you are providing service. You know, you're providing service. You're the one that is serving all. You know why? Service is the key to promotion. If you, every time you want to rise, serve. Every time you want to be the greatest, serve. This is God's own principle. It is upside down of man's principle. Man says, if you want to be the greatest, get involved in office politics. Struggle to be on top. Make sure your eye is on the throne. Make sure your eye is on the pulpit. Make sure your eye is on the MD seat. No. But God said, if you want to be on the MD seat, if you want to be in charge, then go and find how to offer service. Go and find how to offer value. Make sure you are offering value. Make sure you're offering service. That is the key to promotion, and this is how God recommends that we deal with office politics. The moment you start fighting back, God will take his hands off the case and watch you win the battle. You say, okay, since you decided that you want to follow your own principles, you want to write your own Bible, I'm going to allow you to see whether your own Bible and my own Bible, which one would work better. The Bible says that God is the Ancient of Days. He was there before the heavens and earth was created, so he understands how things work. So you need to obey and follow what God has said. So the coping strategy, whenever there is a gang up against you, is what? Find yourself in the presence of the Lord. When you find yourself in the presence of the Lord, no man can find you. The Bible says in Psalm 62, it said, twice has God spoken, once has God spoken, twice have I heard, that power belongeth to God. That makes me so excited, that the power in this world, it belongs to God. And therefore, once I can please God, once I make my ways pleasing to God, then he will cause even my enemies to be at peace with me. In other words, I shouldn't have enemies if I find myself at peace with God. David was one man who was surrounded with enemies, from Saul to the Amalekites to the Philistines to all these people. But that's why he kept on looking and seeking for the presence of God. He knew that that was the solution. God bless you. I'm sure you've been blessed, you've been helped, you've been inspired. Have an amazing day today. Remember, don't fight back. Look for God. Seek his face. And that is where your solution and your salvation will come from. God bless you.